Hello, my Purple Banditos, and welcome back to our Let's Play Pokemon Omega Ruby version. I'm Purple Rodri. Last time we arrived here in Lilycove City after going through a rain shower of trainers. In today's episode, we are going to make our way to a bunch of different areas, but the first thing we're going to be stopping at is right here in Lilycove City. As you can see, there's a big Pokemart. Now, this is where you can buy all the different TMs, all the different items you want. I'm sure you can find Lemon... Nade, water up there somewhere, all these sorts of things. I don't even know. I'm not really gonna go up there, but the only reason I'm even doing this is because right here we actually have another rival battle, and I feel very well prepared. If you guys remember, our team has been doing really, really great lately. Now, I actually didn't go ahead and train them a little more like I said I was going to, just for the fact that I know we have a lot of evolutions coming up, and I just didn't want to skip around too many levels anymore. I feel like Draiger's already pretty far ahead, and Boomy's pretty up there as well, so we'll see how this goes today. Let's go for the discharge then and start swooping in on her team. Wow, Swallow's actually really, really fast. Didn't expect him to get the first move on us there. But I'm not too worried, you know, I'm very confident in our team. I feel like we're building something really good lately, and now that we actually have all six, I'm feeling quite good. You know, even now that we have Tibber, even though Tibber is probably the one I need to train the most. There we go, Kyber's growing levels too. Waylord, alright, I got this, guys, I got this. See? I feel like Draiger's gonna become one of our strongest guys. I know you guys mentioned to me where to get the Manectrite. I will be doing that very soon. Not just quite yet, because I feel like we're actually going to have to do a lot of running around to find Megastones. Because like some of you guys mentioned, some of you guys might not have noticed, all of our team members are going to be able to Mega Evolve. Now, I did that, you know, just for the fact that I thought it would be cool. And by that, I mean I didn't really plan it. It just sort of happened. And how awesome is that? That every single one of our team members is going to get to Mega Evolve. Pretty awesome. I'm kind of excited. So that means, you know, once we get into the Elite Four or to the serious battles, you know, the one Pokemon who's going to have an advantage is really going to be up there and helping us out. Oh, the Blaze Kick. That's probably going to do a lot. Holy crap, it did. He had a crit on us with that? Oh, that's ridiculous. That is absolutely ridiculous. Oh my god. Oh, we almost took it down, though. I'm going to go for another Earth Power. Hopefully, I don't think that'll take us down. We're pretty tanky. Yeah, we're really chunky. Iroh is a boss. I'm so glad we got him. We finally got someone to stand up to the Blaziken. You know, the good thing is, our Tibber will also be able to stand up to it. But, you know, I'm kind of glad we're growing levels and just moving up in life. All right, who's coming out last? Tibber grew to 30 as well. Our team's really about to get a lot crazier, guys. If you guys don't know what's coming, then you're in for a big surprise, a big awakening. All right, let's drop the Lava Plume then. What the heck did he just use on me? Don't take me down. Oh, Mother Fudge. Mother Fudge. All right. Huh, Breloom. Oh yeah, let's send out Elric. Elric should crush this thing. It's Fighting Grass. I know, because if you guys remember when I played Emerald, I used the Breloom before. I have a sweet spot for Pokemon that I use in the past. You know, some more than others. Some Pokemon I connect with a little more. But this should pretty much rock this Breloom down. And I'm pretty sure with that, we have defeated Mei. And we're looking good. Now, I know she mentioned going into the Pokemart or whatever it was. Now, you don't really have to go in there unless you want to. Like... You know, I'm personally not really gonna go in there. I kind of just did this for fun. And with that, guys, Kaiba is evolving. So, fantastic. We're gonna have an Altaria now, which is really, really great. And now, I feel like that might not be the only thing happening today. I feel like we're gonna have a lot of different little changes coming up. So, I'm kind of excited to see that. All right, guys, with that, it looks like congratulations. Our Kaiba evolved into Altaria. And we are looking quite good. It looks like all our Pokemon... are really shaping up. Oh yeah, I definitely want Dragon Breath. I'm gonna go ahead and forget Cotton Guard. A grass type move on a flying type, I'm not big on that. Let's go ahead and learn Dragon Breath then. And with that, our Kaiba has evolved. But wait, guys, who else is evolving? Not Elric. Hit the B button, hit the B button, hit the B button, hit the B button. Yeah, sorry Elric, you're not gonna evolve. My B, dude. Maybe soon. And there we have it, guys. So now Tibber is evolving. Yeah, all our Pokemon are just at that level where it's like they're just going to start going crazy and maturing all at once. I feel like all of our Pokemon are actually like fully evolved now, except Elric, which is pretty cool. So with that, guys, we have ourselves a Sharpedo, which looks just like a shark head. It looks like it's missing its whole body, but very, very cool. So with that, guys, we're going to go ahead and learn Slash as well. It feels like we're learning so much here. This is great. All our Pokemon are just growing on us. It feels like we just started a little bit ago, but this journey is just beginning. All right, guys. With that, we defeated Mei. Let's hear what she has to say. This reminds me of the battle I had with you back on Route 103. She says that, but when we battled her, we totally kicked her butt, and we only had one Pokemon. It's been completely different. All right, May. Well, I'm ready to get going. I'm ready to go on our adventure. I want to catch you later. Thank you for your help. Thank you for helping evolve my Pokemon. And now, as I mentioned to you guys, you know, I've been saying this for a while. I said that Elric is very close to evolving, correct? Now, here's the fun fact, guys. When you have other good friends who also like playing Pokemon, once in a while, they help you out. Now, I actually had a friend of mine who was a very nice guy. I hit him up and I was like, yo, dude, do you have a Dawnstone? He said, yes. I said, can I have it? He said, yes. So with that, guys, yes, it is finally time for Elric to evolve. I know, it's been forever. I finally got the Dawnstone from my friend. We traded, he transferred it over to me, and now we are finally ready to evolve Elric, and I am very excited for this one. This was one of those final ones that I was like, am I ever gonna get a Dawnstone? Thank goodness for my friend hooking me up. And with that, guys, look how amazing that is. Congratulations, our Elric evolved into Gallade. Very awesome. Your Ralts has to be a boy, and you have to have a Dawnstone in order for you to get a Gallade. So with that, we're looking quite good. And I should actually go ahead and let me go back really quick. Let me just heal up our camera up before we go any further. But now we have a fully evolved team. As you can see now, everybody here on this team can Mega Evolve. So Sceptile, Camerupt, you know, Altaria, Manectric, Gallade, and Sharpedo can all Mega Evolve, which means we have a pretty awesome team. I'm actually very, very excited about this team. I think we're gonna put in a lot of, you know, good time and efforts into it. And we'll see, you know, what trouble we can get ourselves into. Hey, Nurse Joy. How you doing, Nurse Joy? You know, I was sitting there talking to the other Nurse Joy. She told me you guys were cousins. She kinda got mad. She kinda got mad, Nurse Joy. And then, you know, I stole like 3 Pokeballs in the back and I traded them over for better Pokemon. I wonder traded, got some rare Pokemon, you know what I'm saying? Just kidding, I've never wonder traded. I've always thought about doing it, but I feel like people who wonder trade probably just put like, I'd be a sleazy wonder trader. I'd put like Zigzagoons in there and like just really terrible Pokemon that no one ever wanted. And then I'd hope to obtain like really, really good like legendaries or something of that sort. Oh, wait, why was there a Nurse Joy right here? Oh, how you doing? How you doing, Nurse Joy? I like your little cat thing. What is this little cat thing? Oh, wow. She has no interest in us whatsoever, guys. All right, so today... Oh, wow. Guess what? I completely forgot that we need a Pokemon here that can surf. So it looks like we're actually going to have to take a Pokemon back, which is absolutely fantastic. Let's go ahead and fly back then. I gotta go get Zagu out. I know, guys. It's been a while since we've seen Zagu. I know. I don't know what he's been up to. He's been chilling. He's been running around. He's been, you know, hitting on the other Latios and the Pokeball. I don't even know what's going on. I actually have another Pokemon here in the box, which I know is going to seem weird to you guys because I didn't actually catch it. Who am I going to put away? Let's put away... Huh. Altaria. Yeah, we can train up Altaria later. I don't think we'll be... Wait, no. Altaria has Fly. Son of a fudge. All right, Camerupt. You had your share. Let's go ahead and withdraw. So I'm going to go ahead and show you guys the box. I know. It's going to be weird. There's actually a Machamp in here for my friend. That's how he traded me over, the Dawnstone. And he also wanted his Pokemon to evolve. So, yeah, just a fun fact for you guys. Not actually my Pokemon there in a Pokebox. I got to give that back to him now. Because if you guys have actually tried to trade Pokemon, it's different now. Like, if your Pokemon no HMs, you actually can't trade them over. I know, it's weird. It's like this new thing Pokemon's doing, where if, like, Pokemon have HMs, you can't trade them over to other trainers, which I thought was really, really strange. But I guess it's just something they're doing so people don't get an advantage and have Pokemon with stronger moves. You know, it does make a lot of sense, and it's kind of cool in a way. But I just thought, like, come on. Like, I can't even trade my Pokemon, my friend's Pokemon back to him until I get rid of that HM. And one of the pros, though, now here in Lily Cove City, this is where we actually can get rid of the HM. And that's really cool. Like, you can go and talk to the move deleter. I know it's a little bit later in the game, but at least we can do it. Where the heck is Mount Pyre, by the way? That is where we are headed, guys. All right. Well, let's go ahead and make our way inside then and see what awaits us inside of Mount Pyre. Ooh, okay. This is, hey, what's up, peeps? This is very dark in here. Man, what is going on? Everyone just seems to be just really sad. Let's go ahead and battle. Wow, this is weird. People are just like really depressed here inside of this tower. And whoa, we got a... Wait, is this the ghost girl? Because I know I mentioned to you guys last time, I was like, yo, I think the ghost girl's in here. but I don't think she actually was. Maybe this is her now. Oh, and also, guys, thank you for just telling me that I need to train up Tibber before the next gym. I'm definitely going to be doing it. I know I say that a lot, but I am definitely going to be training up. Don't even worry about it. You know, that's something that I'm definitely going to take care of. You guys have absolutely nothing to worry about. I'm going to be doing a lot of training off screen. The only thing is that it does take a lot of time. It's very, very time consuming. That's the only bad thing about training, is it just takes forever. I don't know why. I never had to train this much in, X and Y. So I don't know why I'm having to do this. Wow, that is a good move. How much is discharge? Yep, see you later. We're going to go ahead and learn this move then. And ta-da, Dragger forgot it. We learned Wild Charge. Wild Charge is a very strong physical move. Boomy's also growing levels. How about, there we... Of course, Zagoo just comes back. Zagoo just comes back to gain a level. That's what I've been trying to stop. Like, I don't want Zagoo learning things and gaining levels, but for some reason, Zagoo has been in the box for like 2-3 episodes, comes back still stronger than half of our Pokemon. That's just how life goes sometimes. All right, let's head up on up the tower then and see what other mysterious things we can get ourselves into. Ooh, a Pokeball. I'll take a Super Repel. Are they even Pokemon in here? I think there are a couple ghost types in here. I'm not too sure. I don't mind bumping into these. I'm going to go ahead and battle these trainers after, guys, so you don't really have anything to worry about. I'm just running through here right now just to save us a little time and just so we can figure out, you know, where exactly it is we need to go. I think I'm going to use a Repel, though. I'm pretty sure there are things here we don't want to bump into. Okay, we're doing quite well. There's a lot of trainers here, so I'm definitely going to be going back and training here. So don't worry about that. Wait, what the heck? Maybe some of these aren't even trainers. I see a lot of little ghost girls here. I don't even know the story behind that. I got to figure that out. The whole ghost girl thing. I feel like it's something creepy, like some creepypasta thing. But hey, what's going on over here? What are you guys doing? I'll take a TM. TM30 Shadow Ball. Heck yeah. All right. Shadow Ball is a great move. Let me know who I should teach it to, guys.
It's not good enough yet. For a final resting place that my Pokemon Meow and I will be in, this is not good enough. Why is he so particular about it?
Wait, is this not where we're supposed to be? What the heck is this? We found a Medichamite. Well, that's pretty cool. I'll take a Medichamite. Maybe this is not where we're supposed to be, guys. Maybe I was supposed to do something before going here. Do you guys think I was? I'm actually not too sure. All right, I'm going to run around, and I'll be back in like 2 seconds because I think I missed something. All right, guys, I think I figured it out now. There's another exit down here, which I didn't actually have the chance to see, but I'm glad we actually found that Medichamite. I think that's pretty cool for any of you guys who are using Meditites or whatever it is. Congratulations. You got yourself some Medichamite, Medichatite, Metagross, Metanoz, Metanose, beat the meta, beating the meta, going out of the meta. I don't even know. Mechanite, Metanite, Meditite. Alright guys, we're almost on the way to the top of here. Oh wow, look at this! Alright, take a minute to soak that in. Holy crap, that is beautiful! They've really expanded. That is huge! Wow, imagine the amount of space this is taking up right now in this game. Compared to when you play this on like, wow, on like the Game Boy Advance. This is insane! This looks so freaking beautiful. Okay, that really just like took my breath away. And we're gonna have a lot of battles here, guys. So let's just go ahead and kick some butt. I'm probably gonna speed through them. So here we go. Well, that was pretty easy. I actually want to put Gallade up in front, though, just because I want to see the Gallade out. I want to get some action going on this guy. And with that, guys, let's go ahead and take on our next battle. Oh, the perks of having a Mega Evolved Pokemon. We have another battle. Okay, so with that, I think we're looking good to make our way to the top of this mountain. I'm gonna go ahead and heal us up, though. I've also been picking up a lot of, like, health potions and things like that on the way, guys. So no worries, you know, I'm slowly but surely doing things right and stocking up our team and just preparing everybody for the get-go. But I think up ahead, I might have seen someone that looked familiar. So let's see who it is.
So it was you! I'm sorry I had to postpone my defeat of you at Mount Chimney, and now I am sorry that I have to postpone it once more. I cannot afford to waste even a single second now, for the Red Orb, which has long been enshrined here at Mount Pyre, now belongs to me, the Great Maxi. Courtney! Huh? You must see it to that our dear visitor is not neglected due to my inability to battle.
Wait, why can't this guy battle? Is it because we crushed him so bad last time? Because if I remember correctly, pretty sure we whooped his butt. I might have slipped up a little bit. I might have, you know, misclicked a couple moves, but I felt like I did a pretty good job. So with that, all right, Maxie's going to run away from us, but we're going to be taking on Courtney. What an intimidating name. You know, if I was a part of Team Magma, you know, and they were giving me thug names, Courtney is the first name I would go with. You know, I feel like that is the one that's going to shake people in their boots. You don't mess with Courtney. You know, when people would look at me, they'd be like, dang, that Courtney. That's one bad person right there. That's one crazy, crazy, you know, Team Magma grunt. You don't mess with the Courtney, they would say. All right, guys, the camera upped. I actually didn't expect it to be a camera up, so that's going to do a lot of damage to us, but I'm not even worried about it. I'm just going to kind of go into this and just chill and knock things out, because if I remember, we're about to get something real cool. Wow, we're actually doing a lot. Okay, come on, survive this. Survive it, Elric. Okay, I think we're going to take this thing down. Come on, come on. Don't use a potion. Yeah, awesome. Yo, so Gallade, actually super strong, takes down the Camerupt, and I didn't even expect us to be that strong, but awesome. We gained a bunch of XP. We defeated Magma Admin Courtney. Funny. Just like your name, Courtney. We got 3,800 for winning, guys, and looks like, you know, we kicked some butt.
Again, that's unanticipated. I knew it. You're interesting. I'm looking forward to when we can meet again.
All right, Courtney, hit me up. You got my PokéNav number. You know what I'm saying? If you gotta hit me up with the digits, you know, let me know.
Aye, what a disaster. The Red Orb stolen from our safekeeping.
The Red Orb and Blue Orb must never be separated. They belong together.
I will entrust the remaining Blue Orb to you, young one.
All right, well, thank you, Grandma and Grandpa. It looks like they have just given us something we've been looking for a very long time, guys. With that, whoa, what the fudge just happened? What the heck? We obtained the Blue Orb, and something really weird just happened. I don't know if it was just me.
And I beg you, chase after those thieves and take back their orb. That wretched leader of theirs. I'm sure he said they were headed for Slateport City next.
Okay, guys. So we have obtained the orb, but I'm really not too sure what the heck is going on here. It seems like there's a lot of crazy things going on. Did you guys feel that glow there? Yeah, I felt that glow. It felt like something weird just happened when we touched the orb. Something activated. Really not too sure. Next time, guys, we're going to continue from here in Lilico City. We were told to go towards Slateport, but I'm going to do a little bit of training beforehand. So if you guys have any tips on what's coming up, let me know. Make sure to give this video a like. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next episode. Goodbye.